Hi everyone, this is Kenny and welcome back to my channel. Recently, one of my clients told me he's seen a lot of his friends buying and selling property, but he himself held on to it for many years. And only until the age of 50 plus where he decided that he shouldn't wait any longer to take action. In today's episode of Property Analysis Series, let's talk about what do they mean by swapping properties and what you are missing out from this method. In the first scenario, imagine you purchased a unit in Livia back in 2008, 99 years leasehold with 724 units for 650 PSF. Fast forward to 2013, highest PSF was $1,071. And based on the past transactions, 1539 square feet unit was one of the most transacted unit sizes in Livia. Potentially, we are looking at a profit of $647,000 if you decided to sell it back then and you've made the decision to purchase a new launch unit in Coco Palms. Coco Palms was launched in 2014, 99 years leasehold with 944 units. If you have gotten a unit at 1000 PSF and sold it off in 2020 for 1404 PSF, we are looking at a potential profit of $404,000 for a unit size of 1000 square feet. In fact, with just two swaps alone, will fetch us a potential profit of $1.051 million. But of course, this is just an ideal example of property swapping. But what I'm trying to bring across here is that not every property behaves in the same manner. I'm also not saying that all of us have to swap properties in order to make money. As a matter of fact, we have to be on a constant lookout to understand the market and whether there's ample room for growth for our current property. Or are there other properties out there that can offer us a higher growth? I've seen people who bought their unit and held it for 10, 20 years without knowing how to research or analyze. If they had done it sooner, they could have bagged a good profit depending on their financial capabilities. Next, we have an example in Hougang, and if you're an owner of Rio Vista, Riversound Residence or Kingsford Water Bay, you must not miss this. Back in 2002, the average PSF for Rio Vista was about $450 for a unit. Fast forward to 2012, units were selling at 900 PSF. In fact, based on the most transacted unit size at 1249 square feet, we are looking at a potential profit of $562,000. Let's say you made the decision to swap properties to a cheaper new launch, Riversound Residence with an average of 845 PSF. And sold it off 3 years later at a high of 1032 PSF. With a unit size of 1163 square feet, your potential profit is around $217,000. Continuing on this streak of swapping properties, you went straight into Kingsford Water Bay, bought at 1135 PSF and sold it off at 1413 PSF. With a unit size of 1033 square feet, we are looking at a potential profit of $287,000. In fact, with 3 swaps in this scenario, it will fetch us a total potential profit of $1.066 million. Based on this chart, if you knew about swapping properties back in 2018 to 2019, what would you have done? Let me know in the comments down below. And if you are one of the lucky owners of Riverfront Residences right now, you are potentially sitting on a gain close to 150 PSF before moving in. In fact, the top reason for swapping properties isn't just plain selling and purchasing. We must be able to spot the opportunities in the market and make the right choices. As of today, is Riverfront Residences still worth entering? Or are there similar projects in other areas that are showing telltale signs of swapping? If you are someone who missed the past opportunity to swap properties, or is interested to know which property is best suited for you, or to find out whether this is viable for your situation, do drop me a message for a property health check and don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button. I'll see you soon.